the afterburners and demonstrates the awesome power of the CF-18 with the impressive takeoff, dirty roll, and Cuban 8. Selections using the 16 buttons on the stick and throttles. L'emmener ainsi le nécessaire de chercher l'intérieur de poste de pilotage pour trouver le bouton critique tendant en combat aérien. This is especially impressive considering the speed and agility needed to make effective tactical decisions during combat operations. Regardez maintenant, Morton Bones demonstrated the capacity exceptionelle de la CF this week. A verde tono from the right, the quad 270 roll. Maintenant, Mudum, those demonstrate there the capacity exceptionnelle de la CF this week. A fair tono from the left, the square loop. Thank you. Son concept a été concrétisé par les techniciens en structure de la première escadron de Maiden's Air et la quatrième escadron de Fort Lake, spécialisé dans le painter de cette polaire. Operational gray color palette this year reinforces the theme of fighter operations at home and abroad, while the geometric pattern on the wings and tail are a reference to the wings of the CF-18's namesake, the Hornet. Get your cameras ready as Modem demonstrates the topside pass. The next pass will demonstrate the agility of the Hornet in changing direction. Modem will fly the aircraft in a maximum rate 360-degree turn. Will monitor all speed and capacité de Hornet to effectuate a bouc et angle d'attaque ailée. Durant l'execution de ces virages, Modem résistant l'effet de force d'accélération 7 fois supérieure de la force de gravité. This means that in the cockpit, his body weight will rise to nearly 1,500 pounds. To the red hot afterburners in the tailpipe. Flying under offer inspiration, his best parent could not perform a CC aujourd'hui, who's inspired by Tom Vodka Craig. If that means becoming an RCF fighter pilot, an aircraft maintenance technician, or something else, we hope that you find your inspiration here today. Modem is now configuring his aircraft with landing gear, arresting hook, and refueling probe deployed. With everything hanging out, Captain Higgard Smith sets up from the right for the dirty inverted pass. Behind the enemy into what fighter pilots call the control zone, a pilot must occasionally slow down. The avion qui peut voler le plus le monde gagne l'avantage. Captain Haggard Smith will now demonstrate the high angle attack capability of the Hornet at a minimum speed approaching center stage of only 190 kilometers per hour, qui est sans la vitesse de croisière d'un helicopter Griffon. Prepare to be thunderstruck as Captain Haggard Smith approaches from the left with the high alpha pass. as Captain Eggert Smith pulls to the vertical for a 7G straight to the sky. From the west, we have the West Coast crew from Four Wing Cold Lake, including Crew Chief Master Corporal Timothy DeVolder from Revelstoke, British Columbia, Deputy Crew Chief Master Corporal Steve Benoit from Angatosh, Nova Scotia, Master Corporal Nicholas Bougeau from Cassapique, St. Jules, Quebec, and Corporal Adrian White from Eastern Passage, Nova Scotia. Let's give them a round of applause. I think Modem is feeling the need, and I think I know what, that you know what need that is. The need for speed, of course, to the prochaine minute, the CFTC, Polarella, Sulamanta, Motis, the Vitesse Maximal, but half the speed for Hornet is still more than 1,200 kilometers per hour. Flying right on the edge of the sound barrier, watch from the left for the high speed pass. Smith in the cockpit of the CF-18.
Go away, this is Modem coming back to you from the cockpit. I want to say a big thank you for all of you coming out tonight. We've had a ton of fun up here. I hope you guys have as well. I want to say a big thank you to all the volunteers who make this possible. Without them, we wouldn't be having a show today. So a big round of applause to the volunteers. Modem out.
Dernier passage, during which time he will be waving to you. He can see you, so make sure you give him a wave back. We would like to thank the amazing organizers and volunteers that made this great event possible and everyone who came out to see us.
Only keep on flying. just traveling.
Gentlemen, that concludes our performance today. We'd like to thank you for your attendance. And now I'll head you back to our air show announcer, the man with the two hockey pucks, Mr. Kent Hildebrand.
Thank you very much, Kent. And Ken Jacobson doing an outstanding job on the narration with the CF-18 Hornet. Ken, I gotta say, we're gonna bring the Hornet around, and they're gonna be landing shortly and taxiing by, and they'll be going back to the performer parking. I think later on this afternoon, they'll be with the F-22 demo team to sign some autographs. Still lots and lots of air show to come, folks. We're just getting started. Gord Price is coming up next in his Yak 50. We're going to have the CH-148 Cyclone helicopter demonstration. 410 Squadron and 437 Squadron are here with an air refueling demonstration. Kyle Fowler is going to be back in the sky doing a full aerobatic routine in that incredible long, easy aircraft. The United States Air Force F-22 Raptor demonstration team is here. They've also brought a P-51 Mustang from the Heritage Flight Museum that's based in Skagit Airport down in Washington State. And at the controls of that P-51 Mustang will be Greg Anders. And then we're going to wrap things up with the Canadian Forces Snowbirds. With the CF-18 on the rollout, here comes Gord Price taxiing out his Yak 50.